In this chapter, we will look at retouching techniques and the different tools that are available for this. We start this chapter with the clone tool. With the clone tool, you can copy one area of an image and paste it onto another area. This technique is often used to remove elements from an image. I have opened Organ. In this image, I want to remove the wire at the left. I click on the clone tool or press S. I will start here to remove the wire. I zoom in to about 300% to have a good view. In the tool options, I will choose a soft brush with 0% hardness. I set the size of the brush to 20 by alt scrolling. With the clone tool, I am going to place pixels from the environment over the wire to make the wire disappear. To work non-destructively, I will work on an empty layer above the image. This way, no pixels are overwritten. I am able to clone pixels from other layers than the layer I am working on, because in the tool options, Sample Merged has been activated. With Sample Merged checked, everything that is visible is being treated as a single layer. I will use these pixels at the right and place them over the wire here. If I press the Control key, in the circle I see a little cross. The middle of the cross is the middle of the circle. The cross can help with aligning. I press the Control key and hold the Control key down. I place the horizontal line of the cross on the edge of the beam and I click. Now I release the Control key again. If I now move my mouse to the left, I get a second circle. The second circle shows me where the pixels from the first circle are going to be placed. Inside my second circle, I have a white arrow that points to the middle of the circle. If I point the white arrow to the same edge, the circles will be aligned. Now I click and drag over the wire. As long as I am holding my mouse button down, I am duplicating pixels. I release my mouse button again. I will do also a piece under the beam. Now let's look at the result at 100% by pressing Ctrl 1. As we can see, we made a piece of the wire disappear. Because we cloned to a separate layer, the original layer is still intact. This way, I am flexible in making any changes later on, if needed. I paint a bit more over the wire. Because the right side of the wall is a bit darker than the left side, we see a bit of a dark stripe. I will press the Delete key to clear the content of my layer. I will zoom in again to 300%. I will stay close to the wire when I'm cloning. I make the brush size smaller to size 10 and give it 100% hardness. I will try cloning from the left side, which is the lighter side of the wire. I control click close to the wire and remove a piece. I press Ctrl 1 to have a look. I think this looks okay. It is not noticeable. Let's explore the difference between using a soft brush and a hard brush a bit more. At the top, let's remove the pin in the wall. I zoom in to 300% and set the brush size to 30. I will first remove the pin with a soft brush. I will take my sample at the top right corner of this brick. To align my clone, I start cloning at the top right corner of this brick. Now I draw over the pin. Let's do the same with a hard brush. I draw over the pin again. Now we can see the difference. The larger the brush, the more likely it will be that you will need a soft brush. When you work with a very small brush, for example size 10, a hard brush is often the better choice. Finally, let's have a look at the bottom, where the wire goes over the wood. I zoom in to 400%. To remove the wire, I will set the brush size to 20. Because there is a lot of detail, I will take a soft brush. In the next lecture, I will let Gimp remove the wire at the top.